Hello, I welcome you all in this video lecture series on mineral metabolism. In this video lecture, we will discuss about sodium. Sodium is the principal cation of the extracellular fluid. Near about 50% is present in the bones, 40% in extracellular fluid, and 10% in soft tissues. Let's see what are the different biochemical functions carried out by sodium. Sodium helps to regulate the acid-base balance as it is a chief cation of the extracellular fluid. Sodium is required for maintenance of osmotic pressure and fluid balance. It is also necessary for normal muscle irritability and cell permeability. Sodium is involved in the absorption of glucose, galactose, and amino acid from the intestine. It also initiates and maintains heartbeat as it helps to generate the signal in SA node and AV node. It helps to maintain normal functioning of a neuron. It plays essential role in generation of action potential. Normal individual required 5 to 10 gram per day of sodium, and the common salt is the best source of sodium, whereas the hypertensive patient who has the history required less than 5 gram per day, whereas the patient who is hypertensive required very less amount of sodium. Sodium is readily absorbed in the gastrointestinal tract, and therefore very little is normally found in feces. However, if a person is suffered with the diarrhea, large quantities of sodium is lost in feces. The absorption of sodium is directly coupled with absorption of organic solutes like glucose, galactose, amino acid, and water-soluble vitamins. Normal plasma concentration of sodium is near about 135 to 145 milliequivalent per liter. Sodium is an extracellular cation, therefore the blood cells contain much less, that is 35 milliequivalent per liter. Mineralocorticoids influences the level of sodium in the plasma as well as its excretion in the urine. 800 gram per day is filtered at the glomeruli, and out of that 99% it get reabsorbed. If a person is suffered with extreme sweating, then the sodium loss in perspiration is get increases. The plasma concentration indicates that the amount of sodium relative to the amount of water in the extracellular fluid. It not provides direct information about the total body sodium content. Let us see the various disease states related with the sodium. The diseases are hyponatremia and hypernatremia. Let's see first hyponatremia. When the serum sodium level falls below the normal, it is condition called hyponatremia. It occurs due to diarrhea, vomiting, chronic renal diseases, Addison's disease, overhydration, and congestive heart failure. The manifestations are reduced blood pressure and circulatory failure. Hypernatremia is the condition where there is increase in the serum sodium level. It occurs due to Cushing syndrome, prolonged cortisone, adrenocortical tropic hormone, sex hormones therapy, and dehydration associated with diabetes insipidus. And the manifestations include increased blood volume, increased blood pressure, and edema. Hypernatremia signs and symptoms can be recalled with the word fried. In the fried, F stands for fever, flushed skin, R stands for restless, I stands for increased fluid retention and increased blood pressure, E stands for edema, and D stands for decreased urinary output, dry mouth. In this way, you can able to remember the hypernatremia signs and symptoms. If you like this video, then do not forget to subscribe to the channel. Till then, happy learning. Bye-bye.